fountain of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Good evening. And welcome, my friends, as we gather at this celebration, a celebration of thanksgiving, to thank our God for the life he has given to these graduates, for his being present to them in their journey thus far. And as we ask him to continue to bless them, to continue to guide them, we also thank God this evening for their parents, their families, and friends who journeyed with them and supported them throughout the last 12 years or so of education. You are all very, very welcome as we gather in this place where our God is. For wherever two or three gather in his name, he indeed is here. As we begin our celebration, we pause for a moment. For you and I in our journey have not always been what we have been called to be. We have not always been faithful or honest or truthful. We have not always done our best. And as we begin this celebration of the Eucharist, we pause, acknowledge those failures, and ask the Lord to heal us and to strengthen us to continue on our journey. Let us pray. God and Father of all gifts, we praise you, the source of all that we have and all that we are. Teach us to acknowledge always the many good gifts your infinite love has given us. Help us to love you with all our heart and all our strength. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. You now sit and listen to God's word.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is a reason for everything, a time for application under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing. A time for throwing away stones, a time for gathering them up, a time for embracing, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away. A time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking. A time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, a time for peace. What does a man gain for the efforts that he makes? I contemplate the task that God gives mankind to labor at. All that he does is ask for his time. But though he has permitted man to consider time in his wholeness, man cannot comprehend the work of God from beginning to end. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. All I ask, turn down the road. Before you, we have a word of your location. Bear with one another, charitably. Complete self, listeners, gentleness, and patience. Swallow your wounds to preserve the unity of the spirit, but please have harmony together. There is one God, one spirit. Just as you are our God, and born into the same home, and you are God. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God, one Father, above, over all, throughout, and within all. Each one of us, Lord, has been given his own share of grace, given his first of others. And to some, his gift was that vision of the apostles, to some, prophets, to some, evangelists, to some, pastors and teachers, so that the saints together may make unity in the work of service, building up the body of Christ. This way, we're all to come to unity in our faith and in our knowledge of the Son of God, until we become the perfect man, fully mature with the fullness of Christ himself. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Session before our God. must pray for the folks in our politics and for the church leaders, that they may lead the people of the depth of God and the right path to save James to come.
Lord, hear our prayer. For our bishop, Bishop Alphonsus Penny, our parish priest, Father Joe, and all bishops and priests who need our help and support in bringing the church forward to its renewed strength and courage into the 21st century. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the church and the people of God, especially those who sit up here, that we all share an active and caring concern for each other as Christians, Christ's example and gospel teaches us. Lord, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray especially for those who are sick and not able to be with us this evening, and for those who have died, that they too can share in our joy this evening in our own way. Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
All right, we have our prayer.
For our teachers have grown up, they have taught us and supported us for the past 6 years, and for our fellow students, that God will bless them and the work is like this. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we have our prayer.
For our parents to help and support us during our school years, in gratitude we ask God to bless him and the care for him out. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each member of the senior class here today, that God will bless each of us and continue to be with us at this stage of our lives in education, and what we can new and unknown challenges, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear us in our need as we come to you in prayer. Bless your people, wherever they may be, and instill in us your spirit of truth. We ask this through Jesus, our brother, your son. Amen.
Thank you.
our Almighty Father.
Give you thanks, and giving the cup to his disciples, said,
the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
Thank you.
This is Jesus Christ, Son of God, He whose way we are called to follow, Him whom we acknowledge as the Christ, that we will now share His sorrow. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. The body of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
When the time of our particular sunset comes, our
Let us pray. Lord, may this Eucharist, which we have celebrated in memory of your Son, help us to grow in love all the days of our lives. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
May he look upon you with kindness and give you his peace. And may Almighty God bless us all. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We want to once again to thank the love of Christ. Thanks be to God. And great God, we join in the fun and the station. We now pray.
bit the dust long ago. There she was, getting ready, a little nervous. Now she didn't have that, the money was not enough. Here she was, searching for the other tissue. And then she said, I know I have two on my left.
It wasn't easy getting here, but I guess we've got a time.
Mathias, and a few other roles, probably with you and put out as well. You read the morning when you were in the air? Come up a few of those. And if your mom and dad came down and said, you said, I don't want to go to school anymore, I'm sick. And your mom and dad said, get off, you're not sick. You said, I was in all of this. I guess that morning was a great time to try to do it. Do you remember all those tips you didn't bring home? All the two winters you didn't do too well on, and you said, oh, cool, I'll bring them home. But you found a new way. But we got a special skill as parents. And you don't have it yet, but you will get it eventually when you become parents. Today, I was watching Gold go on Girls for a couple seconds there, and I guess you all heard Sophia. Sophia refers to it as that radar. That adult doesn't know what's going on in his mind of children. And we can be kind to do. We work hard. For all those bruises, bumps you had, and how we made you feel better when you came in crying. Remember the best friend that deserted you for the boy or girl that was down the road? How we made you feel better when we consoled you? Remember when you first broke up? At one time you were studying for your atmosphere, finished high school. But I think now they go to kindergarten or something like that. For all those things, we were there. Parents. But you know, we parents have an advantage in getting you where you are today. And I think the advantage we have is the very high school teachers. Very high school teachers, I think we owe you a great debt. You have made school for our sons and daughters like a home away from home. And we thank you very much for that. You've been second parents to our children. You've learned to push when you need to push, and you've learned to coax when you need to coax it. You've helped them learn, you've helped them mature, and you've helped them have fun. As I quote Mark Twain, a famous American writer, granted 1990, as you jump on your horses and ride out in all directions, good luck to you. I believe you know where you're going. I wish you well. Thank you very much.
Please stand for a close to our teachers.
The success and happiness that has just come from the future comforts of this world that you are dreaming about and hoping for, maybe at this moment in time. Basically, it's in the midst of the ups and downs of life, if you can attain inner peace and happiness and contentment, then you can be very successful. Good luck and God bless.
Thank you.
graduates, his table guests, parents, teachers. Mr. Kilobyte tells jokes. I'm supposed to make people cry. And I'm going to do the graduate today tonight because they have endured me for a number of years. Now I'm going to make their parents endure me for a while. Well, as I sit down to write something to say to you, and it seems like every year it gets a little harder because he looks back over the things he said, and sometimes you find yourself repeating. However, as you're growing older, I'm always happy to be here because I know their number now. And I'm always glad to see young faces and to look at young people full of enthusiasm, as you are tonight. I think to be among graduates tonight, as we begin a new decade, is not just an exciting challenge. You have started well on this challenge when you, as a group, decide to have that your night tonight will be drugs and alcohol free. I know it involves a very serious decision, and I want to congratulate you for making that decision. I just wasn't a moment this morning. And I'm sure I am very proud of you. The school is very proud of you. And I'm sure your parents are very proud of you for that decision. After 12 or so years in school, you have become equipped with what we call formal education. Now, this formal education I have seen to equate with some charts. However, knowledge, like a chart, is a very good use if we do not use it well. We got to use a lot of understanding and a lot of good judgment if they're going to be successful. You cannot do all the things at once, and if you're on a boat, sailing yacht, you cannot put all the sails up at one time. It's very windy. So I ask you to be careful as you move out from journey time. When you think of the ship, too, you think of a voyage. And this voyage has many different ports. Like food and wine, it will have many different ports for you. A happy outcome, I suppose, and fulfillment of what you're starting out to do tonight will depend a great deal upon the skills with which you follow your life from one event to another. Tonight, you're able to step out and take on an adventure in the world of work, and you're going to find yourself now that you are going to be the one who's going to be steering your life on. You're not going to have parents or teachers after you sell off. We, school, your family, and the church have provided you with the report cards. We have shared our wisdom with you, and now you must apply that with your own talent. You cannot give up now or drop anchor, because if you give up now, that you would deny you the opportunity or your potential greatness. So many times that many of you, especially in the summer, have told me that you're bored. Time is so long. That, I suppose, is correct, and especially for young people like yourself who have so much energy. With this in mind, I challenge you tonight that you need, as you leave the school, to assess your capacity for doing things, and let it be your ambition to do the work that you can do best in an area where you need it, and then
but also require us to discriminate and to choose. We look around ourselves today in our idle world. Perhaps many of us are giving poor example to each of our youth, because sometimes perhaps we are selfish and about to think based on the principle of living our own things. We often go along with the crowd and turn a blind eye to some things that are both legally and morally wrong. Perhaps it's because we don't have the courage to say no. I urge you to look at the values you have been taught and to stand up and fight for what's right rather than going along with the crowd. Tonight, the beginning of your Exodus. Remember, those of you who are in my religion class, those with the Exodus, Moses leading the Israelite people and out to the promised land of Egypt. Thomas Merton, in writing about this, Thomas Merton, one of the great writers, he said that he was observed that there are many people who leave Egypt with few to reach the promised land. Most of us stop on the shore of the Red Sea, afraid to get into the desert. He goes on to say, if you put your faith and confidence in God through Jesus, you will succeed. Remember, there is nothing on the east side of the river, the east bank of the river, that is not on the west bank. If you put your trust in God. Now that you are striking out on your own, life will not be a time. It will not be easy. You want your parents to go to all the time. You're going to have to make some tough decisions. And you are going to be responsible for it. You will have to keep your chart up to date. You will have to evaluate and reevaluate the choices and the decisions that you make. You will continue to learn from experience and from others. However, I urge you, as you become active citizens of our great country, to stand firmly on the principles you have been taught. And I ask you to be honest and just with everyone that you meet. Don't forget, too, that you should hone in on your social skills, because a large part of our success depends, too, on our social skills, how we get along, how we deal with people. And as you move away from our school, I extend to you the invitation to come back and visit us sometime. And if you're out for a while, you'll be on Extreme Beach. I've been a little donation for your life.
I'd like to commend the graduating class.
Congratulations. Reed, from drugs and alcohol. I feel that class of 90 will be an example to graduates behind you. I'd like to thank you for your invitation. I'd like to wish you all success in the future. And I certainly hope that you have a very good time. Thank you very much.
Jim Riggs, Will Scranton, and Desmond Forward, and You know, I can't believe some animals taking this world. First is that, and now this. Can Mr. Dwayne Penny please stand? Thank you. teach us that he'd rather attend a new beach or be some cool down his track pants to go swimming. He also pulled down his trousers. You better like yourself, my dear.
So one of the classmates said, "Nicole, it's fireball man. I'm sure it's easy to fall."
young lady is very quiet. And all the years we've known her, she said nothing to no one. All herself. You see, Dina would time for herself and great dream for her, and now I think she's starting to answer herself because she's still alive.
Secondly, now I know why I've got a huge dent inside my chest. trunk after a couple of glove brands, so
don't you want to know if you're going to be looking? They don't care who's here. We want to work. But I am going to finish by just saying one more thing.
really proud to hear that everybody's involved in state bread. I'm not going to talk about how wonderful state bread is, but there's ways I think is very dead. I'm not going to talk about how nice it is for your parents and everybody's very dead. But I am going to tell you a couple of stories about my experiences. Last year we saw Golden Bones, and we had one person sent to St. John's for the spinal injury on bread, not the state bread. This is a safe weekend as far as I'm concerned. And just remember, I'm on call this weekend, so if anybody comes in, congratulations to everybody here. I'm very proud of your children. I know all the teachers are hooked off by themselves. And have fun tonight because it's probably the last time we're all going to be together again. And although it sounds like a cliche, I can honestly say that I look back and wish I had one more thing to keep life in this program. And you are all going to wish that at some time in the future. Enjoy yourself tonight. Have fun. Have a ball. Good luck. Goodbye. Take care.
Thank you.
call upon now Mr. Jason Dix to give us a session of voting. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
permanent figure and added to our system here. She gave us a fitting thing to the soul and help us in our number. We thank her for her guidance and company. Without further ado, we would like to welcome the candidates, the next local fire, this college to come forward and take the stage and deal with our issues.
Let the march begin. First,
supported by Melvin Hillier.
Thank you. Now, don't put your feet on the ground, so I want to put them there myself. Go close to this one. Keep feet still. Keep feet still.
Thank you. Yeah, bye, wave to the camera. Okay, everybody wave to the camera.
Oh, wait. Mr. Chairman.
Aye.
Let's go again.
Oh yeah, me, sure.